guys, Sammy here, and welcome to day one of this 2-week tone up challenge. If this is your second time through and you are starting your second week, this is day 8 for you. Maybe you're just popped in for a solid cardio and strength workout and you're not actually doing the 2-week challenge. Whatever it may be, get ready. You have 8 moves to go through. They are going to be 45 seconds on, 15 seconds off. We're going to go through it 3 times. I really want you to pay attention to your form and the structure of your body throughout each movement. Yes, there will be a clock. However, I don't want you to feel like you need to race that clock or squeeze as many reps as possible into that 45 seconds. I didn't label this a HIIT workout because I didn't want you to come to this thinking, oh, it's high intensity. I don't know if I'll be able to get through it. If you do want to view this as a high intensity interval training workout, that's perfectly fine. It is applicable as one and can 100% be completed as one. Or if you're on the opposite end and maybe you're just starting out, I will be going through correct form as well as modifications for each movement. And as we progress, you will see yourself progressing and you will get more flexible and your squat will deepen and that eccentric phase of your push-up will deepen. You will get stronger and you will be able to move faster through these movements while keeping that correct form. Everyone has to start somewhere. And if you're flying through these movements because you want to see how many reps you can fit in before that clock runs out, but you don't have correct form, you're not doing yourself any favors. And in the long run, you will be doing more harm than good. So just be sure that you are checking in with yourself. That being said, keep in mind that this is a cardio workout. So we're really going to put an emphasis on bringing that heart rate up and keeping that heart rate up throughout. So do push yourself and do make sure you are still challenging yourself. This entire workout can be completed with just your body weight. Feel free to add weights if you would like to. And while we will be upping the intensity, it is low impact, so shoes are optional. I would recommend hopping on some carpet or using a mat if you have one. If you want to do this outside, get in the grass, anything to add a little extra cushion for when you're on your knees or on your back. I would also recommend grabbing a towel because we're gonna get sweaty. Prop your phone up somewhere, your computer up, blow this up onto your TV, and we will get to it. We'll get started with a little warm up here. Just come onto your mat, feet a little wider than your shoulders, hands straight out at your sides. We're going to bring that hand down and cross to the opposite foot, bending that knee as you tap that toe, really warming up that core. Make sure you are glancing up to that hand above you to open up that chest also. Exhale as you tap down, inhale back to center. I'm gonna turn to the side here in a second, so just keep doing what you're doing. I'm just gonna give you a better visual of bending that knee and sitting those hips back. On your next rotation, we're gonna take a nice inhale and come into a low squat here. Feet turned outward, feel that stretch in your hips. We're gonna exhale the hands down and press up through those hamstrings. Inhale, returning to that low squat. Find a comfort here. Whatever feels good for you, go at your own pace. Exhaling up, inhaling back to your squat. Feel a stretch wherever it works for you. When you're pressing up, make sure you rotate those toes from outward to straight forward. If your hands do not reach the floor when you are extending up, maybe just bring them to your thighs or your calves. Don't force anything here in the warm-up. Exhale the hands down to the mat and step those toes back. We're gonna walk the dog. And
and then we're going to come into a cobra position, dropping those thighs, those feet to the floor, stretching through those hip flexors. We're going to extend back into child's pose and stretch out those shoulders, warming up the core, warming up those shoulders. Exhale back into child's pose, putting those knees a little bit wider than your shoulders. Coming to all fours, we're going to come to a full standing position. Inhale, arms up overhead. Coming into our first exercise here, we're going to hinge at the hips, exhale, and squeeze those shoulder blades together. Squeeze that glute, that hamstring, and bring that leg up and back. Keeping that bottom foot planted, that knee behind the toe, hinge at that hip as far forward as you are comfortable with. Make sure you are exhaling every time you bring those arms and that leg upward, and keeping that core tight the entire time, really strengthening your stabilizers. And maybe right now you are placing that foot onto the floor to help you maintain balance. The stronger you get, you won't even need to touch the floor. Coming into our squat lunge here, we're going to stay low, squat down. We're going to alternate our leg that we lunge backwards with. Same leg, same arm. Going to come to the ground, keeping that front knee behind that toe, and make sure you're keeping your chest up so you're not caving down and rounding out your back. And you can come into a full standing position after each of these movements if that feels better for you. Otherwise, stay low here with me, and we're gonna pulse and keep tension throughout every movement. We're going to switch to our right side for our single leg airplane. So make sure you are exhaling every time you contract to pull those arms backwards and pull that glute and that hamstring up. You're really gonna feel this in that leg that is planted on the ground. Again, working to really strengthen those stabilizers. I actually completed this entire workout prior to this video, not with the intentions of going through it without you, but unfortunately my camera decided not to record the first time around. So if I look like I'm running out of steam at any point, that's why. Three times is a very decent workout, I now know from experience, and six is 100% overkill. I'm powering through for you, and you better stick it out with me. We're coming into our power mill with the floor tap. So keep that core tight here. I want you to exhale every time you turn your body. So one, two, three. You should be exhaling every time. Tight core throughout every movement, even the bend. Keeping that core tight will help you to keep your hips facing forward and not turning outward as you turn. Thank you. Coming down to the floor, we're going to do oil diggers. So square those hips to the floor. We're going to keep our elbows tight. Go as far down as you are comfortable with. And then we're going to squeeze those glutes and that hamstring, bringing that leg up. And then in that push-up, everything returns back to center. So come down wherever you are comfortable with and press up and through those triceps. Make sure you're keeping your elbows tight to the sides of your body. Don't push them outward. Next, we're going to come into our candlestick roll up. So slowly roll onto your back. We're going to bring the legs up and rock our body to a full standing position. You can use your hands to assist here and then pushing up to standing. Otherwise, stay right here with me and keep your hands chest level, almost as though you're holding a ball out in front of you. You're going to inhale, rolling back, exhale all the way up. Inhaling down, exhaling, pulling your entire body up, engaging your core the entire time, keeping that head, neck, and chest lifted. Try not to sink into your chest as you're rolling through. Coming to our opposite side for our oil digger. So hands on your shoulders, extend that left leg out. Make sure that right knee is under that hip. We're going to lower, keeping our elbows tight. Raise that left leg up overhead and return everything to center on that exhale as you push up and through those triceps. Coming into our last move of the first round here, we're going to put our arms straight up overhead. We're going to come into a front lunge and we're going to alternate right to left, always keeping that knee behind that toe. If your arms are a little tired or if your shoulders hurt, putting them up overhead, maybe bring them to your hips or maybe at a 90 degree. Otherwise, stay with me, arms way up overhead, keeping that heart rate up as we power through this last move. Always remembering to breathe. Give me an inhale as you come forward. Exhale, pushing yourself back to center. Inhaling down, exhaling back up. Just like that, round one is done. How you feeling? A little sweaty? A little out of breath? Me too. Stick with me. We're going to get through this, going straight into round two with airplane to the right. So exhale every time those arms and that leg come up, keeping that bottom leg strong, chest high, neck up, really contracting those shoulder blades together, squeezing those glutes. I really felt it on that one. In case you couldn't tell, that's what that little dance was there. Coming into our low squat, low lunge. Pulse it out. Try to stay low here with me. If you need to come to a full standing position, that is perfectly fine. Go at your own pace, whatever is most comfortable for you. Try to push yourself though and stay low and pulse it out. We're going to come into our single leg airplane on the left side. So get in position, hinge at those hips, keep your chest high, really pulling back, pinching those shoulder blades together, squeezing those glutes, exhaling every time you pulse backwards, keeping a strong core, those hips squared with your shoulders, and a strong foundation through that leg that is planted on the floor. Keep that core tight, arms at shoulder height, rotating through, exhaling 1, 2, 3, and down, inhaling up, exhaling 1, 2, 3, down, sitting those hips back as you hinge forward. Coming down to all fours, we're going to go into our oil diggers with our right leg. So get those palms under the shoulders, that left knee under the hip, lowering down, elbows tight, pressing up and through those triceps, returning everything to center. Bring that booty to the ground. You're going to roll onto your back. Engage that core, bringing those legs back, rolling all the way to a full standing position. Remember your hand placement on the ground if you are more comfortable with that assistance. Otherwise, keep your hands right at your chest level. Inhaling down to the mat, exhaling, propelling yourself up. Inhaling down, exhaling all the way up. Oh, back to all fours. We have our oil digger on our opposite side. Square those hips to the mat, bringing that leg up. Palms under shoulders, knee under hip. Lowering down as far as you can. Pushing up and through those triceps. Returning everything back even to center. Coming into our last exercise of our second round, we have our victory lunges. So start out, hands overhead, see how it feels. If your shoulders are tired, your arms are tired, bring your hands down to your hips or maybe just to shoulder height. My shoulders are on fire right now, but I want you to push through. As long as it's not painful, I want you to push yourself. As we come into this last round here, yes, last round, I want you to focus on yourself, not so much on me. I'm gonna turn the music up. You'll have the timer here on the screen, and we're just gonna power right through, and then we'll come back together for a nice cool down at the end. Bye. Awesome job. Grab some water. Stay with me. We're going to come into a cool down here so we can gradually bring that heart rate back down. Take a wide stance and just ease into a side lunge. We're just going to alternate sides. Remember to breathe. Grab your towel if you need it. We're going to go onto our left side here, placing our forearm on our thigh, raising that right arm up overhead, opening up that chest. If you can, bring that hand down to the ground, pressing that shoulder into your knee, really opening up that chest. Inhale up to center, coming to a forward lunge. Bring those hands to the mat or to your thigh, whichever is more comfortable. Lowering that back leg, that back foot, and really stretching through that right hip flexor there. Keeping a nice space between your chest, your belly, and your thigh. Bring your hands to your mat, raise that back knee up, lower it back down. Inhale it up, and then we'll just rock back and forth a little bit, stretching out those legs. Thank you. Extending that front leg, flexing that left foot, keeping your chest high. I don't want to see you arching over like this. Chest up, stretch down to wherever feels good for you. If you can reach your foot, go for it. If your hand can touch the floor, otherwise keep them right on your thigh. And feel that stretch through your hamstrings, through the back of your calves. Make sure you're flexing that foot. Coming forward, curling those toes under. We're going to walk our hands across the middle, coming onto our other side, placing that elbow, that forearm on top of that thigh, extending up overhead. And if you're comfortable, bringing that palm down to the floor, pressing that knee into the back shoulder, really opening up through that chest. Don't cave forward. Inhale, come up to center. Exhale, we're going to bring that arm back and open up, feel that stretch through your obliques. Inhale, cartwheel the hands down to the floor, coming into that low lunge, placing your hands wherever you feel a comfortable stretch. Everything should be pain-free motions here. We're going to stretch out that left hip flexor this time, lunge forward, keeping that chest open to wherever you feel a comfortable stretch through that left hip, keeping that belly with a nice gap between that thigh. Make sure you're not arching that back. Stay upright, chest high. Curl those toes under and hike that leg up. Bring the knee down. Back up, and we will just rock back and forth, stretching out those legs. Straightening that right leg, flexing that foot, keeping a nice high chest, hinging at those hips. You should really feel your heart rate gradually decreasing at this point. Go ahead and grab that foot if you can. Place that hand on the floor. Make sure you're not arching your back though. I need to work on my flexibility a little bit because my hand cannot quite touch the floor on this side. Go ahead, come back to your lunge. We're going to raise up and walk the hands to the middle. If you can touch the ground, great. If not, maybe you just bring your hands to your thighs or grab your elbows and just allow your head to drop, sway back and forth, feel a stretch, whatever is good for you. Listen to your body. Keep your toes pointed forward and walk your hands to the right side of your body. If you need to keep your hands on your thigh, do so. Otherwise, bring them to the mat. Make sure those toes are pointed forward. We will walk our hands to the other leg and really feel that stretch through those abductor muscles. On your next inhale, come back to center. Inhaling the arms up all the way overhead. Allow that blood to flow. If you feel a little lightheaded, stay here for a moment. Exhaling the arms down. For this next move, don't round out like that. tuck that tailbone in, suck that belly button in. We're going to extend our arms up and overhead, and then out to the right, really feeling that stretch through that left oblique. Inhaling to center, exhaling out and over to the left, making sure that tailbone is tucked under and you're not rounding out through that lumbar. We will come to a forward fold. If your hands can come to the mat, that's fine. Bend your knees. Allow that chest to really sink into the tops of your thighs. Again, grab your elbows here and just allow your upper body to hang and feel that stretch through your posterior chain. Inhale to a flat back. Exhale, bring it all the way down to the mat here. Feels good to sit, yes? Hug those knees in, rolling onto our back. Give yourself a nice little hug here. We're just gonna massage the spine a little bit, rocking right to left. Find what feels good for you. Maybe you bring the neck up, pulling your knees in tight. Find a nice massage. Extend those legs out straight, arms extended all the way up overhead for a full body stretch here on the mat, allowing yourself to really sink into the floor, relaxing those shoulder blades, those thighs. Inhale, exhale, stay here if you would like to, otherwise we're going to bring those arms down your sides. Roll that spine all the way up. Come and grab your feet if you can, extending as far forward as you feel that stretch through your back, through your hamstrings. Inhale, roll all the way up to the top. And that'll about do it. Feel you're nice and relaxed after that wonderful workout. Give me a thumbs up so I know you'll be back tomorrow to continue this 2-week tone up challenge. And I'll see you soon.